Have you ever wondered why does diamond sparkle so much? Or why do we see mirage, which is an optical illusion? Herein, you see water on the road, when actually it is not there. The answer to both your questions is total internal reflection, which we are going to study in today's class. Before moving to total internal reflection, we will have just a brief recap of refraction of light. So what happens according to refraction of light when the light moves from rarer medium to denser medium? It bends towards the normal. And when a light propagates from denser to rarer medium, it moves away from the normal. Now the same knowledge is going to be used for explanation of total internal reflection. So let's take a denser medium, a rarer medium, and we'll make light incident from the denser medium to the rarer medium. Now what will happen when the light is incident normally on the interface? It means your angle of incidence is zero. So what will happen to angle of refraction? Yes, that also is going to be zero. Hence, no bending. Now, what if I increase the angle of incidence? Keep in mind, the ray is traveling from denser to rarer medium. So it will bend away from normal. And here, the angle of refraction is going to be more than the angle of incidence. This is all because the ray is traveling from denser to rarer medium. Now, one point will come at a particular angle of incidence that your angle of refraction will become 90 degrees. This particular angle of incidence for which your angle of refraction is 90 degrees is known as critical angle. Now what should happen if the angle or the ray is incident at an angle greater than critical angle? Here we are discussing the ray is incident at an angle greater than critical angle. Yes, this is total internal reflection, wherein the ray has bent back into the denser medium following the laws of reflection. So what is total internal reflection? Total internal reflection is complete reflection of a ray of light when it is traveling from a denser medium to a rarer medium at an angle greater than critical angle. So of course we have two conditions involved here. First, the light must travel from denser to rarer medium, and the second being the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. Only then total internal reflection will happen. Apart from these conditions, what is the difference between reflection and total internal reflection? The difference is, in case of total internal reflection, 100% of the light energy reflects back, which does not happen in case of reflection, which makes TIR the very important concept in physics. Now, same phenomena is used in optic fiber as well, and it is used in endoscopy. Herein you can see the internal organs are illuminated using an optical fiber, and the bigger picture or the magnifying picture of those internal organs are seen on your screen. So in the next class we'll study more about different applications of total internal reflection. Thank you.